So the sun was setting, it was getting dark, and we were traveling down this very narrow road when all of a sudden this gigantic explosion. And there was a wall on the right-hand side of us, which just was packed full of HME, homemade explosives. And it exploded out, twisted the Striker like a Coke can, and hurt a bunch of people inside. Some engineers from the Striker behind us deployed out to try and get the Striker either chained up and to drag it off, see if it could run, what the status was. And as they were chaining off the Striker to another Striker, we were just ambushed. There was enemy forces all along the rooftops, and they launched an RPG into the middle of the recovery team. And so the recovery team became the team that needed to be recovered on top of the other already wounded folks. And so the soldiers in my Striker decided that they were going to go out and try and do some body recovery and get a status. And at the time, it was me, the driver, and then the squad that was in the Striker. And they said, well, who's going to man the 240? And I was like, don't worry, I got it. I'll take care of it.
It's a machine gun.
It's a machine gun, yeah. So there I was, a unit I wasn't familiar with, in a vehicle I wasn't familiar with, in a town I was very familiar with. And it just seemed very surreal. So I took my Kevlar helmet off, which is, you know, your typical helmet you wear, and took that off, placed it on the seat, and picked up the Striker helmet so I could hear all the communications going on between all the gunners and the drivers and, you know, all the commanders. So the Striker ramp goes down, and the soldiers are running out into a mess, and rounds are firing, cross-firing from the rooftops. It's everywhere, and it's like Swiss cheese. It's coming into the Striker, and all the bullets are ricocheting in and out. And the driver's yelling at me in a lot of explicitly deleted words to get the ramp closed. And I hadn't been in the Striker just a few times, so I was sitting there looking for the ramp close button. To say it was chaotic is an understatement. And all the while, trying not to get shot in the face. And so I finally find the button, and nothing happens. It's like, nothing, because it's hydraulic, right? And I hit it again, and I hit it again, and I hit it again, and nothing happens. And finally, the driver engages. He's like, clear. And he engages it from the front. I get up on the weapon, and I start doing what I'm supposed to do. And as I look down, one of the soldiers is dragging another seriously wounded soldier to the end of the Striker, and he looks up and makes eye contact with me, and he says, come get this guy. And he's hurt pretty bad, and then he just takes off. So I jump down from the gunner's nest in the rear of the Striker and look for that button again, just praying that it opens. And so I hit it, drops down, and all of a sudden it's like, again, barrage of bullets just spraying in from everywhere. And all I'm thinking is, I need to get this guy, and he's literally, a pool of blood is just spreading from underneath him, and he's unconscious. But he's unconscious, but his eyes are open. It's the eeriest thing. And so I just kind of zero in on him and try and forget everything else that's going on. And I just run toward him. And as my foot's about to take a step off of the ramp, the Striker helmet I was wearing goes tight. And I forgot I was even wearing the Striker helmet at all. And so it goes tight, and it literally, like almost like a cartoon, my feet come out from underneath me, and I just land flat, and my neck hits the edge of the Striker ramp. And it was this very same place that I had injured before. Lucky for me, I had a lot of adrenaline coursing through my veins. So it stung pretty good. It knocked the wind out of me, but it wasn't enough to incapacitate me that I couldn't do what I had to do. So I took the helmet off, and I threw it off, and I put it in the Striker, and I ran up to the soldier. And I could see the blood was coming from his neck, but I couldn't see how bad it was because he was wearing his individual body armor, and it was up on his neck. So he's twice my size, and he's got a full combat load on. I'm like, this is ridiculous. How am I going to fireman carry this guy? How am I going to drag him off? And I just said, okay, I'll drag him. as far as I can. And that's what I did. I would grab him, I would pull him toward me, and then I'd fall back down. And I did that. It felt like forever, but I'm sure it was only a couple minutes. I got him up on the ramp and I drug him into the striker. And next thing I know, there are about four walking wounded guys. Like, one was shot in the shoulder, another had shrapnel to the face. They all had their own problem, you know, they all had their own wounds. And they were all sitting on the bench just kind of waiting for me to tell them what to do. There was no medic yet. I mean, I don't know where he was. And I could feel the pain like searing down my right arm, but I still had enough adrenaline that I could just keep pushing through it. And so we're just cutting away at this guy's body armor, and I just rip it open, and I realize that he has a laceration from the back of his ear all the way down to his collarbone, and it's nicked a bunch of veins in there, and even an artery, and it's bad. And he wakes up and he starts screaming, and so I took these two fingers, my index finger and my middle finger, and I just stuck them down in his neck and pinched off the vein where I felt the pulse coming from, and I just held it. And I started screaming for the medic at the top of my lungs. And the soldiers on the bench, feeling like they had nothing else that they could do, started to contribute, and we started screaming loud enough that finally it was almost like the best scene from a war movie where the smoke sort of swirls around and running like in slow motion, it feels like the medic could not get fast enough. And he runs in and he throws his bag next to me and he's like, "Are you a medic?" And I said, "No, I'm a combat photographer." Yeah. You couldn't have written a script better than that. So we went to town on the guy, and the last I saw of him, he was over the medic's shoulder running through the firefight to...
You know if he made it?
I was told he made it.